Welcome back. If I travel to the US and watch the weather forecast there, I see all temperatures in Fahrenheit. To understand them, I need to translate them to Celsius. But if an American comes to Delft in the Netherlands, he has to translate from Celsius to Fahrenheit. This is an example of an inverse function. Converting Fahrenheit to Celsius is a function with domain the square on the left with all possible temperatures in Fahrenheit, and the range is the square on the right with corresponding temperatures in Celsius. An American visiting Delft wants to go from right to left, that is, convert Celsius to Fahrenheit. This is the inverse function. Note that the domain of f is the range of f inverse, and the range of f is the domain of f inverse. What exactly is an inverse function? Suppose f is a function with domain d and range r. So f maps an x in d to a number y in r. The inverse function goes in the opposite direction. That is, it maps each number y in the range r back to its original x in the domain d. In other words, if y equals f of x, then the inverse function is a function f inverse, such that f inverse of y equals x. How can you find the inverse function? For example, take f of x is equal to 3x. The domain and range both consist of all real numbers. We start by setting y equal to 3x. Now the inverse function maps y back to x, that is, f inverse of y is equal to x. If we solve the equation y equals 3x for x, we get x equals 1 over 3 times y. So we see that f inverse of y is equal to 1 over 3 times y. As you know, we can use any letter for the variable of a function. And usually, we use the letter x for the variable. And we also do this for inverse functions. So we replace y by x, and we find that the inverse of 3 times x is 1 over 3 times x. You just saw how to find the inverse function. Solve the equation y equals f of x for x, and then interchange x and y. But does this always work? Let us look at the function x squared. To find the inverse function, we must solve the equation y equals x squared for x. This gives two solutions, square root of y and minus the square root of y. And indeed, you can see that, for example, y equals 4 occurs twice in the table. So, if we only know the value of y, we cannot know what the original value of x was. This means that there is no inverse function for x squared. We see that the function f only has an inverse if, for each y in the range of f, the equation y equals f of x has exactly one solution. Functions with this property are called injective. There's an easy way to see if a function is injective. The graph of f must intersect any horizontal line in at most one point. This is called the horizontal line test. If we apply the horizontal line test to the graph of x squared, we see that it intersects a horizontal line at more than one point. So this is not an injective function. However, if we take the positive real numbers as domain of x squared, we see that the graph now intersects horizontal lines at just one point. So now it is injective. In this case, for positive y, the equation y equals x squared has exactly one solution, namely x is equal to the square root of y. Now interchanging x and y, we see that the inverse of x squared with domain the positive real numbers is the square root of x. Let us now look at the graph of an inverse function. Suppose that x, y is a point on the graph of the function f, then y equals f of x. Since x equals f inverse of y, we find by interchanging x and y that y, x is a point on the graph of f inverse. So the graph of f inverse can be obtained from the graph of f by interchanging the x and the y coordinates, which is the same as reflecting the graph of f in the line y equals x. You just saw that the square root of x is the inverse of the function x squared restricted to the positive numbers. So, we obtain the graph of the square root of x by reflecting the graph of x squared in the line y equals x. And in the same way, you can obtain the graph of 1 over 3 times x from the graph of 3 times x. Okay, let's summarize. If f is a function with domain D and range R, then f only has an inverse if f is injective, which can be seen using the horizontal line test. If f has an inverse, then f inverse of y equals x precisely when y equals f of x. F inverse has domain R and range D, and the graph of f inverse is obtained from the graph of f by reflecting in the line y equals x. In the next video, we will use inverse functions to define logarithms, but first, try to find another inverse of x squared by using a different domain. Good luck!